Alright, I'm gonna get seated in here. Do some recording here real quick. Line it up, lower it, and off we go. Oh crap. Oh, this piece of junk cedar. I hate it when you have to cultivate first, Woody. This is stupid. I've had enough. This sucker's done. We're getting that other cedar. That's all there is to it. Alright, you pieces of junk. Cultivator cedar. I've had enough. This is going to be a happy day. Boom. Sold. One more. Sold. See ya. Peace out. Hello, YouTubians. Welcome to Farming Simulator 2015. We are playing vanilla on Bjornholm multiplayer. So we have today, helping me today is Mr. Woody Brydges.
Howdy.
And he's down there doing some logging and I'm doing some farming. And what we plan on doing today is this is gonna be an uncut Farming Simulator 30 minute video. Uncut, no cussing, all that good stuff. It's gonna be clean. We're gonna be talking the whole time. I'm not gonna stutter, no retakes. So ladies and gentlemen, if you ever wanted to think about having me do the entire farming process, here's what it's gonna be like. So episode 5, uncut. So here we go.
About like an acoustical version?
Yes, yeah. Well, that's what we should do, is put some music to it. I'm not even going to fast forward or nothing. It's going to be straight up for 30 minutes. You get to see how to farm. This is going to be wild, because now, Woody, we have to talk for 30 minutes, okay?
Oh, jeez.
Because no dead silence and all that good stuff. Can't have that.
Probably end up talking over top each other.
Well, that might happen once or four times.
No, I'm just up. I'm like a wild beaver up here, and just cutting all kinds of trees down.
Yeah, we need to...
As opposed to the domestic beaver.
We need to get the people on board with that, too. So what we're going to do, folks, is we are going to take and... I cannot multitask. Holy crud. We are planning on deforestationing this entire map from top to bottom. Every bit. Wherever there is a harvestable tree, we are taking it down. So for us to be able to accomplish that in one season of Farming Simulator, we have to start now. So Woody, if you see him up there in the top left of the mini map I've got up here, that is what he is doing right now. That is his project. So what we're going to do for now, oh, go ahead, Woody, if you got something, I'm going to jump track.
I was going to say, this is going to get tough. Maybe it's because you were just up on the trailer.
Yep, sorry about that.
All kinds of leg.
Oh, okay.
The guys jumping around.
Okay. I'm not moving no more. I'm standing still.
Okay. Yep. Here we go.
You want to have a staring contest? I'm really good at this.
Don't blink, eh?
I'm winning. You're moving. Ha! I win. But yeah, Woody's up here going to be working up this end. Gnawing on some trees. So, yeah. So we figure we start up here, since we still have the small tractor, or the forklift and the small trailer, we're closer to the lumber yard. We don't really want to use that semi-trailer that I've got parked right here yet, because we need a semi to pull it. The tractors we have just can't do it. So if we load that thing up full, it's not going to work. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. Tear every tree off this map.
Yeah, so if you like shade, you better get it in now.
Yes. If you like the beauty. So we all need to stand back. Let's stand back, people. We need to have a look. Take pictures. Screenshots. Oh, look at the beautiful environment. Actually, it is pretty beautiful. They did a really good job.
Good graphics, yeah.
Oh, man. We need to come over here and get a vantage point. Have a look. The majesty of Bjornholm.
I haven't been playing that long, but I haven't seen any animals other than the ones you buy, right?
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, there's no animals. No
deer. Well, then, it really doesn't matter.
Failed. Dadgum.
But like
game.
It's not like we're displacing deer or anything.
Right, yeah, exactly, yes. We need to be friendly to our furry friends. No spotted owl problems.
Yeah, there you go.
We have checked, ladies and gentlemen. If you're worried about the spotted owl, Woody and I have gone around and checked every single tree. There are no nests in any of these trees.
Who? Who?
Woody?
Who?
Who? What? Who?
Who?
Hoot? I thought I got your name wrong. When you said that, I'm like, oh, crap. We are going to have to edit it. Dag nabbit. But no, folks, we didn't. I got his name right. See, Woody and I, we play World of Tanks together. And we both have different names on there. So eventually, you're going to hear him slip. He's going to call me by my World of Tanks name. But you can't tell anybody, because I don't want to be all...
Trying to kick you on purpose?
Yeah, you know, because I'm famous. I'm famous. Like,
Oh, yeah.
You know, if you watch, what's his name? Quickie Baby.
Yeah.
He has trouble with that when people see him in chat or in the tank battle. Everybody wants to talk to him. And since
or
I'm,
shoot him.
Or shoot him, yeah. YOLO. It's like that money thing whenever those sheriff guys show up and you get the gold for killing a WGLNA or whatever they are.
Oh, all right, yeah.
Kill the pro or whatever.
Yeah, you better hope they don't change this game so you can go in and
talk
the farmer.
Put a cannon on a tractor. World Tank meets Farming Simulator. Be out here farming your field and all of a sudden you got a Panzer coming over the hill.
Franken farmer. How many trees you figure are on this map?
Oh boy. I mean, if you hit your mini map, the 9 key, holy crud. I mean, just look at the logging zones. Folks, if you didn't know this, if you look at the map and you see those darker brown spots, let me find a place here where I can get rid of the green or the brown. If you see them darker brown spots, like right in the middle of mass, or in the middle of the map next to the biomass heating plant to the east of it, those are logging areas, so they all have tons of trees in them. So Woody, we have a big job ahead of us. Very big job.
I don't know how our... might be trouble for soil conservation.
Well, we might have some erosion problems, stuff like that later on, but that's the future. Pff, they can deal with it.
Yeah.
I'll be long gone by then.
We've got those issues where I'm from.
Oh, I'm sure you do.
Well, now that farming a lot like the simulator's gone, more of a, I don't know, bigger business, I guess you could say.
Yep.
Most of the guys buying acreage, first thing they do is go in and take out all the windrows. Right?
Oh, really?
So there's been a lot of trees cut down in the last couple of years, at least in the area I'm from.
Yeah, turn it into a dust bowl like they did in Nebraska way back when.
Yeah, it's got that potential.
That's scary. I don't know, I'm from Colorado, and I love trees.
Yeah.
It breaks my heart to have to cut down one of my trees in my yard when it dies.
Now, what do you mostly have out there?
Well, pine, ponderosa.
Oh, okay.
We call them quakies. Spruce.
Quakies?
Stuff like. Quakies, what we call them. Yeah, because the leaves, whenever the wind's blowing, they look like they're quaking, I guess. Is where the name came from. I forgot English just now too. While I was thinking about it, so
you're gonna slip into a different language?
Well, no, I was gonna actually use the scientific term for that tree, and then I forgot what scientific what meant. And yeah, you know,
carnivorous. You probably have a lot of carnivorous trees.
Yeah, they eat meat. Yep, that's correct. Yep. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, that's why you don't go for a walk in the forest.
That's true.
Gotta look out for those meat-eating trees.
Yep, them carnivorous ones.
Yeah, it'd be like those old horror movies, right?
Yep.
But instead of telling people not to go in the basement, it'd be, no, don't go in the woods.
Don't go in the forest. Feed me, Seymour.
I got some serious leg.
Uh-oh. It could be I'm picking up straw.
Oh, okay.
It could be. Let me, I'm almost done here, Woody, so if you can hang in there for a few more minutes.
I just hope I don't have a seizure.
Well, don't do that, man. We don't need that on camera. Look away. Minimize
Look
it.
Away.
Go to YouTube. Watch our other videos.
it's just I can't keep an eye on these trees.
Yeah, don't.
Meat eaters is going to creep up behind me.
Yep. Now this game, I love this game. This is awesome. I'm glad you enjoy it too, Woody.
Yeah, she's pretty addictive, eh?
Yep. And you're not sure why either.
Well, that's the thing, right? Like, I know myself, it was just... I guess it's like any other game, right? Where it's got that goal attainment. So you end up, if you're harvesting the field, you don't want to leave in the middle of taking the crop off. You know, it's just like, oh, I'll just make sure I finish this off. And then you get thinking, well, you know, I could probably work around and behind while I get my hired and harvested. And it's like, well, I better fertilize it, you know.
Yeah.
Season, so I don't forget about that. Yeah, before you know it, it's a lot of time put in.
Yep.
And I haven't really got into everything that's on here, right? Like I'm still just cash cropping.
Yep. Yeah, once you start getting into the cows, and then you get into silage and selling silage and the corn and sugar beets and potatoes, they definitely made it to where it's not real quick. You don't really get to in-game stuff real fast.
Mm-hmm. Now, have you put any greenhouses up?
Not yet. No, I have not. That one, you're going to wait until you get to your cattle stage.
Oh, okay.
Because you need the manure from the cattle to fertilize those crops.
Right.
So you'll have to wait on those till you get that. But the bees, you can run bees. Those don't take anything. You don't have to feed them or nothing.
Now, are they much of a money maker?
A little bit. I mean, if you thought about, let's say you've got a hired worker for an hour doing a field, they might pay his wages, maybe. They're not much.
Okay.
It's not enough to really, but they're, you got to weigh it against their operating costs and all that. But if you get a bunch of beehives, then yeah, they'll make their own money. But the point when you start making real money in this game is when you start putting up windmills. They're they're 1.2 million a piece, but you put up, you know, five or six of those bad boys, yeah, you no longer have to worry about money. You're making money faster than you can spend it.
That's on specific maps?
No, that's like, on, they're all, it's all Farming Simulator. It's in the store. If you hit your P button and have a look at placeables, yeah, I think it's in placeables. You should see windmills all the way to the right. And solar does good too if you get buy a field and turn it into a solar field.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Solar will make you money as well.
I guess I didn't scroll through all these options.
Yeah. But those are, like the windmill, that's an in-game type thing. I mean, you can get it. If you get 1.2 million, throw up a windmill, you know. Because then you could AFK.
Okay, yep.
You could AFK your map, you know.
Yeah.
Like go eat dinner or something. Just let that thing sit there fast forwarding on time. And come back and you've made a couple million. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's 2,000 euros an hour, yeah. That'd be interesting to do the math on that to figure out. I guess you pretty well just pick a lot, just throw a bunch of windmills up there.
Yeah, that's what most guys do. You can put them anywhere. You can put them, well, not anywhere, but you can put them around your farm in the trees and stuff like that. It doesn't have to be in a field.
Right.
It's just the field looks more organized. All right, Woody, I am done picking up straw, so you should be able to...
Okay, yep, looks like things have settled down here.
Sweet.
Well, maybe not.
Yeah, I'm getting a little bit here on my end, too, just a little bit of screen tear. It could be just a server backing up or something.
Just once I get close to this tree, it jumps me all over the place. Pretty hard to cut it.
Just that one tree, huh?
Well, it's been a few. we'll see if we can get through her, though.
Hey, Woody, did you happen to look at what time it was when we started recording?
No, I did not.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I forgot to set my timer. It's not running. Oh, well. I'll just check out and every now and then and have a look, see where we're at. I should have done it though. Got the timer going. Now people are gonna, there might be a cut here every now and then just so I can go out and check the time.
Right.
Oh well. They'll forgive me. The YouTubians are nice folks.
They're all out there right now going, liar, you liar.
Yep. They'll be shooting me some comments. I hope. I haven't got many comments yet. I need some comments. Some good ones.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, I think it would be a good thing because, you know, it's like in real life. If you don't know what needs to be fixed, you can't fix it.
Yeah, true enough.
So that's the way I was looking at it, and that's why I was telling people is if there's something I need to fix, I need to know about it. So I'm going to give you a hand here, Woody.
Yeah, I'm stuck in this building.
What, are you taking a coffee break?
No, it's my leg. I can't get out of here.
Holy cow, dude. You got trees down everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
Well, like when I first got here, I thought, Woody, you ain't done nothing. The trees are still sitting there. And then I seen that you're a working man.
Oh, yeah. Getting her done.
Shoot, I can
do a lot more if I put the leg out and end up running 500 feet past where I want to stop.
Yeah. Yeah, that gets frustrating, man. I'm going to stand here. I'm not going to cut trees or nothing. Let's see if we get you caught back up.
Okay, it's settling down a little bit. Nah, I'm still...
I quit moving, so it should help. So the YouTubians and I are going to stand here and watch you work. Okay, Woody?
All right. Yeah. Okay. No, I don't know. Oh, here we go. Ah, we're good now.
Was it working better when I wasn't down here, or...?
No, this seems to be working all right.
Sweet.
Maybe.
Sweet. I mean, I'd say I could...
Yeah, I'm jumping all over.
All right, I'm going to head back up. You just keep doing your thing. Hang in there, man. We only got like 15 more minutes to go, I think.
Okay, yeah, that seemed to make quite a difference.
Negative or positive?
I thought it was better, but I'm still...
Yeah.
Still jumping.
No worries. I hope it's not my internet. My kids are home now, so they're probably watching YouTube and stuff like that. Okay, folks, I'm going to make a cut right here. We're going to see if we can't fix this lag problem real quick, and then we'll bring you back. So we're not doing nothing. We're not doing anything. We are going to start from this moment on. So I'm going to hit pause. Just like that, folks. That game time has stopped.
You lie!
Let's save it. We're going to save it while I'm here, too. All right. We'll be right back, people. All right, welcome back, people. So we didn't really get the lag issue fixed with Mr. Woody, sir, down there. So what he's going to do is he's just going to do what he can, and we're going to stay away from him so he doesn't lag out real bad. And I'm going to keep working here. So this guy's done seeding here. And Woody's just here for moral support today.
Just hanging out on the side of the road with my chainsaw.
Yeah.
That's what you want to see every day.
At least you got your safety equipment on.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, no, I understand that. That gets frustrating when you got lag. It's a pain.
It's funny because it'll calm down, bring it down, and then as soon as I move up to where I can do anything, it comes around.
Yep. Well, my internet's showing I'm running 60 frames a second, so I don't think I'm having an internet issue, but who knows?
It could be server-based.
Yeah, technology.
Well, I think it's a conspiracy. I think they're...
Oh, yes?
Yeah, I think they're out to get Canadians.
That's what it is. I'll bet it is.
Yep.
I'll bet it is.
They want to test the theory that we're easy to get along with.
Well, it's like that movie, Canadian Bacon. That's, you know, the real deal there. You guys are just too nice. It's a conspiracy, so now they're against you now.
Oh, jeez.
We'll blame it on the movie industry.
Yeah. Hollywood. Hollywood. What are you doing there? Are you still harvesting? Or?
Yeah, well, actually, I'm seeding one, and I am fertilizing the next. You want to try and do it? You want to try and see if it'll catch up if you're up here with me?
Well, yeah, let's see what happens here. Which field are you in right now?
I'm in field 38. I'm going to jump out of this tractor I'm in. You take over the fertilizer. That way, if you do have a lag spike or something, it's not really going to mess up the, you know, the lines or anything, because that's completely important, you know. And I'll run the seeder, and we'll save some money. We'll just do this old school.
There you go.
All right, Fred. Get out.
Fire!
Fire! Get out. Had enough of your stuff today.
How many acres is this 38 plot? Does it tell you?
That is a good question. You just put me on the spot, Woody. I'm supposed to know all there is to know about Farming Simulator. And you just found a chink in my armor.
Oops.
Sorry, people. Old habit. I have a habit of hiring a worker right off the bat, but we need to lower it. Turn it on. I think there is, when you bought the field, it shows you in the buy screen. It'll tell you how many acres. But since we didn't buy this field, I never seen it. You know what? I'm going to have to do some research on that and get back to you. You know what you could do, Woody, is before you start, is go to your information screen.
Yes.
The eye, and you can go in there and you can write down or whatever how many acres you've worked.
Oh, okay.
And then when you're done seeding this field, it should tell you how many acres.
Ah.
I don't know if that works for fertilizer, though, because you're only taking, like, every fourth row, so I don't know if that would count or not. And since I'm already...
I'll poke around here and see what else.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have to see if this works.
Too bad you couldn't just go right over top of the...
You can, actually. You can fertilize over the top of this.
Oh, no, I meant as far as the information, the map view.
Oh, yeah, so scroll over it.
Field, get some info on it.
Yep, yeah, I understand.
Although, I did not notice, I did not know you could select which fruit types you got growing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't teach you well enough then.
Yeah, I know, yeah. I'm unteachable.
Oh, dang trainers. So this is how it is, people. When you're not watching us... record, when I do the cuts in my recordings, this is what's happening. We discuss politics and the, you know, life and...
Yep. We're not like real farmers, though, right?
Negative, yeah. I used to farm, but I don't do it no more. That's a lot of work.
I come from a long line of dirt farmers.
Yeah?
Yeah. But at one time, you used to be able to support a family off of 50 or 100 acres. You didn't live too good, but you can still support a family.
Yep.
Those days are long gone.
Oh, yes, they are. Yeah, now it's a supermarket.
Mm-hmm.
So, when you're a dirt farmer, wouldn't now you're going to have to catch us up here, us Farming Simulator professionals.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you sell dirt at? When you grow your dirt and then you sell it?
Well, it's hard to harvest there.
And it doesn't regrow very fast either, I understand.
What you do is you just roll around in your coveralls in the field, and then when you get home, you shake them out.
Oh, okay, all right.
Yep.
Well,
that
wouldn't be a bad day's work.
Yeah, it's like the Great Escape, you know? You just have the bags, and you walk around the yard, empty out the bags of soil.
Okay, all right. I didn't know that. Learn something new every day.
Yeah, most of the, of course, what size of farms do you have about where you're from?
It depends. There's a bunch out here. The farms I used to work on, I think we had like maybe 120 acres that we worked.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Broken up into like 20-acre fields, stuff like that. So it wasn't massive. Now, there are other farms around here. Well, there used to be, where these guys, you know, the fields are like a mile and a half long type stuff. But the terrain I live in, I live on the western slope of Colorado, so the terrain I live in doesn't support huge fields. Because we got mountains and hills stuff. Yeah, this used to be a huge farming area. Well, it started out as a mining area, and then, you know, then the mines dried out, and then it turned into a farming ranch area. And now it's just a people area. They ran the farmers off, and we just have people.
Yeah. Oh, the weeds. You got bad weeds.
Yes. Well, and that's what... Yeah, I am in Colorado, so we do have a weed thing going on here.
I don't know. That's what you should be farming.
Yeah, no. Not for me, man. People have told me that. I should do that. No. No. I don't. I just don't agree with that one. Sorry, folks.
Mm-hmm. No, the reason I ask is I just wondered, hey, because when they did the original survey, I'm from Ontario, Canada. So, a lot of the original survey and that was done here, you know, I wondered if maybe they broke it up different as far as size of farms, as opposed to, like, the area you're in, that would have been surveyed developed as people moved westward.
Yep. Do you guys use townships, like the township system that Benjamin Franklin came up with? So yeah, you're on the same system we have. The only thing that where they ran into a problem was when they got to the Rocky Mountains, it didn't work anymore because now you've got vertical problems.
Right.
You know, when they were out in the Midwest, you know, Nebraska, Kansas and all that, it was easy. They could do the townships pretty simple. But then they got out here, and it kind of messed it all up. We still use, it's still similar to that, but it's not square. It's not, it kind of didn't work out. Right. Now, once you get past the Rockies and get, you know, back west to Salt Lake or something, then you'll see the townships starting up again. Like, if you look at a map of Nevada, the private versus public land, it looks like a checkerboard.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, they still use it. It's just, it didn't work very well in the mountains.
Right.
So yeah, we use the same system.
I learn something new every day.
Yeah, don't we though? If you open your ears and listen, you can learn.
The old saying, open your ears, shut your mouth.
That's true. That's a hard one to do sometimes.
Yeah.
It's like on our first couple of multiplayer Let's Plays we're doing for this series. Boy, I used to talk over tongue pluckered all the time. I'm getting better at it. I try really hard not to do that to you guys, but every now and then. Oops.
Alright, well, I guess I'll get her.
Yeah, give her a shot, because I'm almost done. Go for it. See if it works for you.
Sort of holding back.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, if we make it in time here, you get to see the most exciting part of what we do when you guys aren't around. It is intense. It is so exciting that I just can't, words can't explain it. We've got a minute 58 seconds, so they're not going to get to see the exciting part of this.
Oh, well, maybe next time.
Darn it. How's it working? Are you jumping around a bit? Or?
No, this is good.
I think it helps that if we're in the same area, you know what I mean? Doing the same.
Well,
but
maybe it's just with that the amount of trees I had fallen there. Like you were saying earlier, as far as the objects go.
Yeah, too many entities moving around. Yeah. That's probably it, Woody, you know, because this game wasn't designed as a multiplayer first game, so it's more of a, you know, single player campaign type game. So they didn't really put a lot of weight into the servers, probably, or the engines they used to run the servers.
Mm-hmm.
So no problem. I still like the game. All right, we have done seeding that. All right, folks. So I'm going to give you just a taste here of what it is when we do the exciting part. So we're going to visualize that Woody's done fertilizing there. And here it goes. Are you ready? brace yourself. We're going to hit the escape button. I'm going to turn up the plant growth. Okay, don't get too excited. Don't get overwhelmed. And then I push the 8. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and I'm going to push the 8 key here. Top right, do you see that? Went up to 120. All right, here we go. That was fun. That's what we do. Now we're just waiting for it to grow. And wait some more. Okay, yeah, all right.
Still waiting. But at least it's light out. You're not standing there with your flashlight.
In the dark, yep.
Yeah. Yep. But there's some realism there too, you know?
That's true.
I can remember my grandfather driving around, stopping on the side of the road, getting out of his pickup, going over, kneeling down, checking out to make sure things are coming up.
Oh, yeah. Well, and like when I was doing it, you know, we used to disc and, you know, we'd have to do it in the evenings after we get off work or whatever, and sometimes you had to work through the night just to get it done.
Mm-hmm.
Be out there in the dark trying to disc the field, which is also known in this game as cultivating, just so you guys know. So anyways, folks, we have hit our 30-minute mark. So I'd like to thank everybody for joining us, and if you enjoyed seeing us go through that whole process, I mean, we didn't cut or nothing except for when I made that break just to get Woody fixed with his lag. If you want to see more of that, hit that thumbs up button or let me know in the comments. We'd like to thank you for joining us today. I'm Archer 6D. And that would be, yeah, there you go. And that's Woody Brydges, the guy jumping there. Woohoo! Alrighty, well, thank you guys for joining us. I hope you all have a great day. We will see you next time.